Welcome to episode 4 of Elk Milk on Elk Mountain. We've got quite a load of snow here, as you can see. And we've sorted out some of our issues, but winter has come. Now we've got to deal with it. We've got to try and get through the winter with the feed that we've got left. So, jumping into it here. Got a snowblower hooked up to our tractor. We've got a bit of snow blowing, but first things first, we should head off to the cows. See that they're good to go again. Load of milk to deliver, but might be a bit of a task yet. I'm not sure if the camera has plowed all the roads yet. Might have to jump over and do a slight bit of snow plowing before we can get going. Bunny had a bit of an unfortunate situation with their yard, so it's kind of boring the dealership for the time being. And of course, working all over, clearing the snow. Back up. Let's see if we have the full load here. There we are, full load. Where would we like to deliver it? Prices. Nope. Market prices. We got too far down. There we are, milk. Quite a selection, but the local market offering a price quite a bit better than anywhere else. We've been there before. Oh good, the snow's cleared up for us. Been there before, maybe it's easiest just to start him off there. I don't know if I have a path there yet, so I'm gonna make sure he doesn't hit that pole. Comes and goes, comes and goes. Got a good heavy snow these days like we used to get. Comes back again and stays. Enjoy that. Same with the county yard. The county is in need of a yard. Maybe we'd be best off build the county a yard now that the snow's gone somewhere. Okay, so up there, bit of equipment we picked up. Market's nice and close to this guy. First truck I tried out. It's got a couple trucks here at the stockyard working, getting it cleared up back when there was snow here. It's got a Volvo. Didn't work the best at plowing snow, but we'll keep it around just to try it out. I was kind of disappointed with it though. Also, I was told it was terraform ready, but it doesn't seem to be the case. And then a great snow plowing truck. Yes, two I believe they have. The other one being here. One of their other snow clearing units they picked up. They get through quite a few yards it seems. No problems clearing the roads of these two units. Now we just have to decide where it is. I'd like to put a county yard. I'm correct. I should buy that just for ease of convenience. There's never a farm gonna need to own town like that. It does give us lots of room in this area. Or near the fairgrounds. Everything except for this chunk right here. Not very expensive, but I think that's the used car dealership. If I remember correct, just enter this vehicle and see what kind of options we have here. I don't know if a used car dealership is quite the right place to set up a county yard. But it is kind of a nice yard, just a touch small for what I was hoping for. It's all bush over here though. No real good opportunity to build in here. Maybe we should just repurpose the old used car dealership. It would either be that, or build a yard in this area. Fairgrounds. There's a milk delivery tractor. Here them go. Just kind of out front here. It's kind of a grassy, wasted area right now. Same along with this. Just a big, open plain right here. This one would be a bit harder to connect to the road. But this side of it, it's kind of the same story. How much of that is zonable land? Sitting right on the other side. Into better sawmill territory. Oh, there's a nice little spot too, actually. Seems like an empty yard right now. And a little bit more affordable. Perhaps we should take a look over there quickly. Make more sense for the dealer. Right here might just be a lovely place to put a yard down there. It's affordable. Just for snow clearing purposes, I think I may purchase that. It's a little bit more than we have right now, but luckily, that's easily fixable with some power tools. Don't like to do this too much, but under the county, it doesn't bother me as much as it would on a farm. I'll buy that too. We might need some more just to put up the buildings, but we'll have to see what kind of buildings we want to put up. A little patch there. Maybe this is where the actual yard itself should go. Double check what we own. Seems to be the whole area, but maybe we will start down there. Just because there's already a patch. Not too bad looking. I'll try and make sure it's level. Now we'll try and decide what type of sheds to put up. Interesting shed. Just not entirely sure what the hole in the ceiling's about. Just a big skylight, or it's a good option though. Matches the county well. Maybe another one to park some trucks in, and it's going to be their shop. Gives us a little shed there too. Another good option. Great little shed there too, actually. A little more farm style than county style, that one is. Let's see if that. Maybe we'll go with this one. It's kind of white, like some other big white shed for trucks. I don't think. Just remember how color selectability works. And forgetting that's an option. Changes the look of these sheds a fair bit. You get them in orange. Should we change the roof color too? It's an NM. Both of them. Isn't that interesting? I'll play around with that a lot more. Changes the possibilities. You just have to choose your siding with this color and then oh wow, that looks clean. I don't know if you can do that after you've done building, so. Maybe just this shed and the other shed would be a good start for the county. I'm just very curious on which of these have color selectability now. Not a terrible option either, actually. Matches the county theme. Yeah, it seems like just those early ones were fully color. Oh, this one has a bit too. Nice, it's part of the package though. I've decided. Can find it again? I'll give this one a try. Not a very common shed I use either. It's got a door there, so I think I'll put it somewhere like here. We'll make a little bigger area. Get rid of some of these weeds here yet too. Was asphalt the first one? No. grass, just to knock those weeds down a bit. Control them in the area. A little bit further back. Now the buildings. That second shed I was looking at. Matches quite nicely on that angle I put it. I put this one about here. Oh wait, I put that backwards. It's got full drivability through it. Let's demolish that. Nice, gave me 35 grand back for that, which isn't too bad. I'll try putting it about here. Start. See if this is full drivability. I'm thinking about putting another shed, maybe something along the road right here. Transports. Well, we'll start with just this yard. Now we just gotta make it look pretty. Bit of painting. Kind of interesting, the county has two buildings with a lien, but I guess they just love their liens. Nothing wrong with that. I had a placeable pond in 2019. Oh, those would be nice again. Swing out wide and come back. Under the base of it. Go. Maybe a little bit more asphalt here. Here it's laying me out a bit. Not sure it's enough for all our trucks, but we'll do a little test run shortly. Rather interesting. Not want me to put any grass down there at all. Not quite sure what's going on there, but we'll have to work around that for now. Maybe try again later. It's pretty good for now. Don't want to add too much detail. I don't know how much it's going to grow and change yet in the next coming little days. Just kind of getting it set up here. The grass right there would be nice. And then that's looking pretty good. Switch back over to my dairy farm so I can sell that milk and get him driving home again. And that should about have today wrapped up. I'm surprised all that snow melted, really removed all our work. Alrighty, good to see our money going up. It's getting a little low there. I guess I'm going to have to take more of a loan out, but this we should have about $12,000 more. Quick guess. $12,800. Pretty close. Maybe we should head back to the yard. Happy here. We'll jump back over to the county. Try and get some of their stuff put away. Ready for the winter. I was thinking about it. We might need some way to either fill or hold salt at the county. Some sort of quantity bay or tower silo. So that we can hold our salt there. I'm smaller of a person now. Probably not quite the right size for a county. Have to go in here and open that door. Oops. A bit of grass in here I might have to try and clean up. I'll get the door open. Storage. Perfect for that. Maybe get the two snowplow trucks in here or so. Tuck the grader in beside there and see about the storage options. Oh, snowplows. I have not a bad route for it. Perhaps. On something. I'm not quite sure what it is. Plow is all the way up. It shouldn't have anything interfering with me. System routes. Something comes right near it. Oh, a little coffee stand here. do some this grassy yard here too sometime. Maybe next year we'll put a fence along this whole area and make it kind of blocked off. They have to go through the entrance here. Maybe we can try and put a gate up. Small lip there. That's the first I've noticed that. Oh, prevent flooding? Snowplow trucks. I'm not gonna wanna drive in there with that small lip of the snowplow on the front. Might work to back them and give it a shot. Seems to be barely doing their job. It's looking like crazy, and there's not even any snow. It all melted away already. Lots of room to back a few trucks in here. Kind of interesting, we have to back through our drive-through shed. But, I guess that's the way it goes. I'll leave this truck here for now. Just wondering what they all have. Curious how that snow machine's gonna work when it's about low speed, but it might be great for clearing out yards. Much faster than these trucks if they're in big open spaces potentially. Go there, let's put this wing down. Let's make sure it's getting that done. Start lifting it up another way, and hopefully he can make it there, with any luck. Worry about the other two later. He's already. Very effective at pushing the actual snow. gravel or a bit of grass to get parked in the yard, but there's a bump there to it. Down a little bit, so you can tuck it in the lane. It doesn't turn very tight. There should be a way to pivot this one. Well, this one might not pivot. It'll just be the other the greater mining company that did its Komatsu, I believe it had a bit more functionality than this one yet. This one already allows you to do so much. This doesn't push the snow out of the way quite enough. It gets caught up in your front tire. That's the issue with it. I'm gonna get this a little nicer parked and find a place for the snow machine. Park the trailer somewhere too, quite a nice trailer, and I can make use of it again. Working the right way. This shoe. On the blade. On the trailer. Very nice. Let's go down here for the time being. Get this little guy unloaded. Shut it down, and I want to see if I can take a sec. Handy having that hole in the door now to bash it. It's not letting me do it there. I'll have to do it this way, I guess. That seems to be the grass taken care of. I just have to put some fresh grass, grass down here, sorry. Like that. Hopefully, this grass will find that. Perfect. Take a quick look at what kind of salt storage buildings we could have. If I had just two doors, I'd like that one. That is a very large option. I'll just have to put that back here somewhere. It's an interesting idea, but we're not having four bays of salt. It's just one type of salt. Just regular salt. Interesting layout, but the air getting through the bottom there, you don't want all our salt blowing away. This is a very tempting option, matches this building nicely. That would do the job fairly well of storing our salt. Just based off how nice it matches that building, I'm really tempted to place it somewhere like here. Kind of match the angled laneway coming in, maybe. And put it somewhere to match that shed. Hopefully that ground was level enough where I placed it. It's getting kind of dark to see. Can always replace it later if that's really the case, though. asphalt. One slightly different asphalt I used. Thought this looks a little more like concrete than asphalt, but it should do the trick. Probably should use concrete in the floor if you're going to be picking salt up off it anyway. Asphalt might be a little soft to pick salt up off of. Worry about the decorations later. I'd say that should be good for the county for right now. Ready to plow snow whenever need be. Back to our farm and probably call it a day. See what November 2nd, or is it going to be December tomorrow? It will be December tomorrow. December has to bring us. Close this door first. Fire door. I think that's the door I came through last time, wasn't it? Might be tight, but I'm sure I can make it. Lovely. Got that out of the snow. And I'd say that should be good to call it a night now. Game a save, and we'll be ready to sleep for tomorrow. And good morning. Let's see. Beautiful sunny day. No snow to worry about. Take a look at what our cows are doing. Pretty decent amount of everything. Load them a TMR when there's no snow here, though. Just in case the snow crew. Much to handle. A lot of snow that fell. I'm surprised it all melted yesterday. Quite hoping this would be an area where the snow would stay all year round, but it's quite difficult for the first snowfall to melt away. To do some more mining today. Try and get that gold mine all set up. give the TMR some time to fill up while we go and check out the mine, as there's really nothing left to do except feed that TMR to the cows. So we've got the two payloaders at the mine here. They seem to be happy. Still some snow in the bucket. It'd be hard to come by. I would like to try taking this thing out. Maybe one load up to the top of it. So rather than trying to dig up a hill with the excavator, I can sit on top of the hill and dig the side down. That may be a more productive, effective way of mining out here. I just don't know if this machine will be big enough to do it, or if I should really have a bulldozer to help start building the road. There's already a bit of a natural road there. It's just not very clean and level. So what I'm going to try and do here is level that out. So there's pivot too. There's double tilt. Like the tilt forward. Maybe that's why this thing wasn't plowing snow very well. I'll try again next time it snows. Inside the mine here first, debug off. Sure we're on dirt in this mine. Dirt floor. Should be good on flatten. There. Get a little bit more with it, but hopefully we're down a bit more. Deal with that bump is. I just maybe simply need a bigger machine to do it. Good point. Smooth this area. That's a good leveling action to drag an over it. If I just go back and forth a few times, maybe I can make this more manageable. Radius of a boat. Back up this path. Slowly it's looking better. Get somewhere. Stone roads, old dirt road, just a ticket. Let's drive over it a bunch. lovely little have a whole load to it. That. There we go. Seems to be closer to what I was trying to achieve. Digging it all over the edge and putting it in the middle now. Slowly to the old habit. that once more. Let's see if we get that desired effect on the floor. Level this out again first. Away from that one. Maybe. Just pull its material. Try and use it. Perfect. Thank you. not entirely to plan. See how this path feels in these trucks. If any luck, it should be a lovely, easy night stroll. Say it's perfect, but might suffice just to get us up somewhere like here to load. Try and get a bulldozer as soon as we can. I'll just move those bucks down, but I'll try taking the excavator up there. Farm mod, it's kind of like playing in a sandbox game. Except you don't get dirty, and there's no kitty litter, so to speak. Yeah. I grew up on a farm with barn cats, so it looks like a sandbox to me. It's like a giant litter box for the community of barn cats. So when I was doing excavations, I would find archaeological finds of pieces. I'd like to make this whole place a big water pit. There. Let's go. raw material. Started on the blue course. Just trying to keep the trucks from running directly into each other. Move that bump out, or else you might have wanted to drive off the cliff there, but... We'll see what we do here. Fully loaded, this might be a little more struggle than we're having with it right now. Ooh, it did connect automatically. So, go about your round. So there's a truck right there too. The truck was an early purchase. Hopefully we can get two running on this circuit without much issue. There than I removed. Flat. This top bit. Big, trying to do the hilltop. This guy's still driving away. What? I'm not going to hope to afford a bulldozer anytime soon. Payloader back down there, but payloader's what I want to have down there. Probably want to keep both of these here for right now. So it's good money. And that mine. So I'm gonna move this guy a bit. Buckets in with this guy. Where is it back on that? Trying to get a big scoop of gravel here. Try making a ramp here just to see how this behaves at ramp making versus a payloader. And weird the way it works is less based off bucket height. At least with flat, it might be better to go with lower. Even the way it acts on lower is a little too far. Woohoo! Oh dear, I am lucky I did not flip there. Come on, old girl, you can climb up here. Come on. Maybe a bucket of rocks is making it a challenge driving up this. Wow. Using all its power. Built up after a while. Unless it matters more where you drive in with the light. But yeah, really hard to move the ramp this way. Ready to be loaded again. Faster than it was up there. Which part of the way you're supposed to run an excavator? That bulldozer, I think. Looking at one was 300 and one was 130, I think, I hope. It's a lot easier to afford that one than the $300,000 one, that's for sure. taking a nice, flat, level ramp. This will be the grader and the payloader. Having the ability to see what you're scooping up and the limit on that is nice. Both of them seem to have the same problem though when you're trying to make a hole, is that you end up digging. Trying to get too narrow on it. Yeah, this seems terraform doesn't cut off the height of your bucket. It's just a lower function on where your bucket is, so really hard to get a nice slope out of it that way. Not caps off like this, too. Not quite the ideal. I wonder if you can push material, rocks and dirt, like you can in a silage clamp. Make a nice ramp out of a silage clamp. Practice a little bit more that style than what I'm doing here. So far, this is digging a trench. I'm just gonna mess it up with the grader, because I know it's worked better before for me with the grader, but the grader kind of throws the dirt out my level underneath the blade. Maybe the blade tilts it in just the wrong direction. So many settings you can play with on that grader. Really set interesting angles. I think it is about time to call it a day here shortly though. Just trying to find. Oh, he's gonna drive all the way to the fuel station with a full load to try and get some fuel. I hope he makes it. He is running short enough on fuel as is. It could take him all that just to get to town. Kind of scared if it's going to rain overnight now. We'll do one more load here. So we got that one guy running around anyway. I don't really want to sleep. He's running around. Trying to fuel up in town. The problem is this bucket will be able to be a risk if I get here like this. I just don't like the way that sits, so we'll just help that down. Leave that sit there for now. Maybe turn the beacon off. Very good. Jump back over to the dairy farm. Oops. Break that sooner or later doing that. Tractor sitting out my window. Got a 9220 doing some jizzle plowing, some freshly manure spread corn stalks. It almost might be just wet enough yet though. Glad to get that manure worked in. Gets rid of the smell around my house. Not that it's a very strong smell. I don't notice it at all, but guests might. Dairy manure. That's up there too. So, not as bad as the other animals. At least. Late today should leave us good for tomorrow. About this house. There's no wall in the bedroom. Nice little bathroom here. But the bedroom is just doesn't offer a lot of privacy if you were to ever have kids. Alrighty, see if we need to save, and otherwise we should be good to see you in the morning. December 2nd. I think we should be good on the cow side. Might be some milk to deliver if we're lucky, but I don't know if we'll be that fortunate. Plenty of food, almost a load of milk, maybe by the end of today or tomorrow. How's the price looking? Might be a higher point today than tomorrow, but not a huge difference, so. Drive to refuel station. Better go check on that. Seems something about it is unhappy. Oh, we have enough to afford a bulldozer now, too. Yes. Bit of an issue, just turning into the fuel station. We almost made it the whole way. With a full load of dirt. Hate to pay this fuel bill here, too. No more snow either today, which is kind of disappointing. Missed just having the nice good snow all winter long. Up and ready to go. So we'll drive all the way around the mine to get to the dump station, but did it just? What happened to all the fuel? I literally just saw it had a full tank, did it not? I just missed it on the second set of eyes. I swore the fuel tank was full. Was I looking at something else? Fair bar, maybe? Alright, 420, 460, 480, this time I know she's full. Almost half a grand in fuel costs. We're good. This fuel didn't dip down, I must have just been looking in the wrong spot before. So. Before we decide what bulldozer we want. Also a great way to load manure bags and papers. The best way to load solid manure. Very quick, efficient. I've actually done it in real life too, and it works quite well. Quite well. Doesn't do a great job of cleaning up the pad afterward, but for most of the pile, definitely an efficient, fast way to load it. So here we have two of our bulldozer options. 140,000 for this girl. Beautiful looking unit. I don't know if it has TerraFarm though. I wish it would give me a hint whether it does or doesn't. We'll just sell it right away again if it doesn't. Hopefully not lose too much on it. Way back. Almost ready for another load of tailings. Dang it. I don't see the option. I'm quite disappointed. It's a very nice build though. I'm tempted to keep it just for the material side. Nice appearance. Character. But it looks like the bulldozer we need is $355,000. Ouch. Ouch indeed. Well, maybe we'll just keep this one anyway then. Keep saving for the $355,000 option. They don't mingle too much. Yeah, it's a problem with these paths that I have. Sometimes I don't have them quite right set on the exit. I just drive a little bit too far fast before stopping. Saving for that other loader, I guess. Dozer. Ooh, don't go down the hill, don't go down the hill. Maybe that turn might save me there. It's quite weird about going down the hill. That bucket again too. Maybe I should try cleaning some of this up here. Knock that down a touch. Hopefully we can really enjoy this view. Speed by you there. Big bucket is super handy for this stuff. It's right along. Thank you. here. Got a lot of winter to go through yet. To get to the farming. It's supposed to be a great filler activity. Keep me occupied. Not full time though. Got a truck going to dump finally. But we might as well get this one loaded. Trucks too, these trucks. They cost enough on their own as is. Oh, the truck can't be too far away. We'll just wait a second here for it. Oh, and my other truck is messed up. Must have crashed pulling the bulldozer. Even though he just got here, it seems. I thought it said he couldn't make it, not that he arrived. Must have missed out the message. This guy up here though, not concerning that his gear is turning backwards. I might need to make another ramp up kind of in this section right here so I can level this off. Basically have one excavator up here digging up the top layer, one excavator here digging up this layer, and then maybe just a payloader down here cleaning it up. And at that rate we might actually be able to make our way through this mountain and get it so we can dig this pond out down here. This truck either or sell it because it's just been sitting here pretty much its entire life so far. It's been pretty good those snowplow trucks like the county has. You might trade that one on a snowplow truck though, for the mine. It would maybe be handy having our own snowplow, but we'll have to see what we do with the farm equipment. Yeah. I just think this one thought might come in handy for all our little roads and paths. to Iceland. I believe you've seen the, hopefully, you've seen them in the earlier episodes. Could use if maybe one or two less vehicles in the mine just to organize it out a little bit. Not cycle through everything. Try and find it. This equipment we're looking for. We're just powering on through this dirt now. Get some more trucks rolling. First, I'd love to get that bulldozer. That's kind of surprising. I thought I heard that truck fire up enough. quite nice that you have these splits. So in the narrow parts, they can get through relatively easy like that. And they can split up here and get by each other nicely. That bit of rain, color to the end of the day. It's getting dark. Jump back over to the dairy farm. Get ready for winter time. Let's run our cows page. They're looking to be doing all right. Almost a tank. We should have a tank load tomorrow. Rainy weather, rain in December, wish it would just snow. Snow and stay rather than this rain garbage, but it is what it is, not much we can do about it. Would be nice if the river froze over, get some skating in. The current though, that might not be possible. January 1st, lovely day. Did start off with some clouds, but should clear up. And get our cows into their TMR mixed. Where do we want to deliver our milk to? Prices. Milk. I don't really care about the fluctuation. The local market seems to consistently be the best place to sell our milk. Doubling our money with this load of milk sold. Jiggle. Yeah. episode. Today. I don't know what else is to do except finish delivering our milk and drive back home again. Colors on that kind of bike. Just grab it from here. On the side part. I believe it was on this side. Yep. Yeah. Rolling in the money. Let's see how we're doing on the equipment side, or the mining side, I should say again. Good. Fuck. Oh, a fair few more boxes of concentrate. Difference solutions in this transportation in this trailer. There's another pond. Okay, we'll stack them up, but the weight is going to be on. Crazy. Building. Should be adequate. There's three, because two of them are stuck in the ground. One of them is kind of odd. Hopefully this will give us a nice slow bolt to bring them to the store though. I guess the money we need to afford that nice bulldozer. This is going to rake money in nicely as the mine company. I'm not complaining. because they're just having to try and get to the unload spot. The new deliveries popping up in front. Second here, I'm sure the excavator wouldn't mind loading a truck or two. It's the amount of tailings pulling off at this point now is quite surprising. The last couple times I tried that tailings truck just kind of stood still most of the time, but it's been doing load after load after load. I'm gonna take a train load of tailings to the store shortly too now. The truck just kind of delivers it to the train yard, which has to take it to the cell point for us. So we could have this little profit sitting in those silos. We're going to see if there's a yearly price for actually shipping on tailings. January is the best day to sell it. Successfully. everyone. Pretty well full loads of this trailer of the these things, and I'm ending up with just shy of one. Another second here though. Check how our tailings price looks, if it's yearly fluctuating, or if it's a solid price like many of these commodities are. Tailings, 167. Oh wow, it's pretty solid all year until August, and then we jump around a bit, but November. Not a huge difference though. 178, we're sitting at the low price right now, which is odd. Maybe it just jumps up and down the whole lot. I guess I can check my productions to see if he has anything. Nope. This is all our concentrate. Let's flip it around. Get it delivered. Let's go back to the farm and catch up for the day. To our dairy farm for the night, which can repay some of our loan on. We have lots of money left available in the loan there at any point. But I think we're lovely just to hold tight for now. Just go to sleep. We are January 2nd. We'll check how our cows are doing, but I imagine they're still doing all right. It's interesting how this one does it. It's different on this map than other maps. I wonder if that's because you can produce different types of silage, potentially? I'm not too sure. But I do know. We best mix him another TMR. We hop. over. Is that a floating deer? Oh, there it goes. A little less floaty there. Here through the door. Super strength will get you. Really handy mod though. This doesn't just make you very strong, but just strong enough to pick up whatever you're trying to lift. Save you alone for when I decide to put up a new dairy barn. I decide to put up a dairy barn in fun, because I don't know if it's going to be. I doubt it will be this year or next year, maybe 2 or 3 years. It has quite a bit of storage capability in this barn right now. Hold us open for the time being. For the second day of January. Good to pop back over. Let's see how our gold is making out. Zigzag the stacking pattern. Less chance of falling over that way. That's gonna be about all the gold it's given us right now. sure we're nicely strapped. We'll be off to the races. 17,000 liters of gold. I think this should get us our excavator. Our big bulldozers. Sorry, bulldozers. Oh dear, keep it on the road! Don't lose it! This is way too expensive! Oh dear! Alrighty, managed to save her there. I would be quite bad to lose this trailer worth of gold. I should look at getting a transport truck trailer for it. Something a little safer, potentially. I should grab some fuel while we're in town. Good luck, we'll hit the hill at speed. Oh dear! Oh dear. Well, good job we strapped it. Proper job on that too. That was a good and proper crash there. Surprised the road's less slippery. I guess you get that with gravel. Tires just slide on the loose gravel surface. Doesn't happen again. Things are looking good though. Big open plains here. Oh dear. Here we go again! Oh! It's just the truck this time. Woohoo! Well, that rear axle does not look healthy like that. But, tipped over and off again. Add to the entertainment value of delivering gold. Although I think if I had this much gold on me, I'd be quite entertained myself. I think last time I took gold, I just had this, just a pickup truck load of 3 or 4, and the pickup truck did not handle that very well. But just one in the pickup truck, the rest on the trailer seems to handle very, very well. Just, I'm curious if it was a lot worse without that one in the pickup truck. Here's our tailings truck. Bridge. The water's about the most dangerous thing. If I go in the water, there might be no way back out with the gold. Made it to the pawn shop. This one will sell our gold. That was kind of a tricky spot to zigzag back into. Maybe they're really just supposed to back at it from that side, because those table and chairs do not have to give. Oh, a bit of speed that sucks through too, I guess. Look at the money we're making off that. Oh wow. Look at that fly up. Wow. That is precisely what we needed. $455,000. Well, if you're looking to make money, you got a bit of capital to invest to start off, gold mining just might be your ticket. I think that 400 might have actually been split into two things, because what do we have before? 170? So it looks like we'll be fording our bulldozer today. Might be able to buy a little forklift to help load this stuff too, and maybe even a curtain side trailer. The options are plentiful right now. For sure though, I want to buy this bulldozer with the cage, no GPS. It's gonna need a blade. And we might as well buy the ripper for it too, because we're here, leaving us with $200,000. I don't know if there's a real appropriate forklift that I want to use, or might just keep using this trailer for moving it. Might look at the curtain side. But even with the loan paid off now, we're sitting. We're sitting healthy. I think we might buy a forklift just to have there. Just to have on hand. It really didn't take us too long at all to... on Elk Mountain. Best in gold mining equipment. Time versus them. Time versus reward is very good. Still hauling really good. Ooh, wow. Take this truck. Well, it was thinking about joining the tailings train, so it was. I might have to shortly, because that truck is struggling to keep up right now, it seems. Come on, baby. I believe in you. You can do it. We're bottoming out. So I don't even think the reverse will help us. Oh, wow. There's a slight chance if we hit it with enough speed, it'll work. But considering our top speed is at 17, I didn't think so. Maybe just mental health. I'm old man super arm. This is much heavier looking than the gold. It's trailer. Yeah, try and disperse the weight a little bit better. bit too much on the truck at this point. But it seems to actually be quite well. Here we go. Ooh. Don't know what I caught there. No idea. But we can take off. I thought it was actually the first truck. We've got to pick up our new bulldozer. Hopefully it has the terraform function that I'm also excited to try out. Should be attached to the bucket with the blade on the front of it, of course. Now that I have spent a lot of money on this, at least. This does not look nearly as good as the Komatsu, but yet it does have the terraform we are looking for. So that is pretty, but it is ready for action. There's a fleet for the truck get here to pick it up, and we're in good shape. I'm going to do another load with the excavator while we wait. I do quite enjoy swinging the arm about. Although that might change with these guys rocking their lights on now. So, using my windows. So it does real life too, so. Unrealistic about it, just kind of an inconvenience and annoyance. Look how much dirt. How much gold per dirt I'm actually getting for 100,000 dirt, which is two of these truckloads. I'm getting $50,000 of gold out of it? I should really count my load sometime when I'm completely empty. Knock it out. Might vary though, if it kind of would.
I think it would. Depending on if you're just getting some real good pay dirt, or maybe just some mediocre pay dirt.
Ready for February here now. Flying through winter with ease. I'm just really worried we're gonna have to do a lot of snow plowing. But that really doesn't seem to be the case at all. Probably around March, I imagine, we'll get some snow just to throw a wrench in things. Now we'll switch back to the dairy farm for night again. Get in the house. 8 o'clock sounds lovely for a February morning. Well, there is some snow in the forecast for February too, so let's try and get our TMR mixed before the snow hits. that? Have our cows looking now? It's actually lots of feed. We should be alright to make it through. It'll be close though. A little closer than maybe I'd like it to be. And milk. Ooh, I'm on 2 times. We do have a load of milk to deliver today too. Saw that a second too earlier, but we'll get it done. Probably be worth the market for the best price, I imagine, then. We'll give it a gander, though. I'll have a check, just to confirm. Local market, still around $1,700. Better close this barn door back up and go back over to the dairy or the contract inside for a little bit to sort this mess out. Forecasted accurate, but we potentially have snow before we get a chance to use the bulldozer anyway. Weird little spot we're sitting on. Get up just a little bit more. Get up. That makes me a lot more comfortable. This kind of pit we're digging. So things are looking good. We'll try smoothing this kind of out, down and around. create another level here. I have to try smoothing this out too. Let's see if we can push it all off the cliff over here or so. Four of those trucks. And there's a milk truck too. Don't want to forget about him. Make it. This truck's gonna be holding up for a while. Maybe. Drop it down. Low gear. Lock the diff. Locking the diffs seems to help. Oh, she just moving. She just took it off. Try that. Both those are out. Quite excited about that. Here comes the snow. Not quite as excited about that. Give us an opportunity for the other thing I was thinking about. It's kind of like gold. It's that I was thinking about the miner getting into the lime spreading business. Something I never like to do too much, but seeing as the builder's producing the lime here, it would make logical sense for him also to own the company spreading it, you know, vertical integration. It's a dairy farm, I can buy a lime spreader, but they rarely ever use. fact you can't unload the lime with fertilizer spreaders make them quite annoying in a lot of situations. Going out and come on, Billy, pull her out of the ditch and get her home. Maybe snow soon. If it snows while you're on a hill, I don't believe there'd be any hope of getting this truck out then. We're just bringing the forklift back home. Second. She's picking up speed now. She's past that hill. She'll be in the clear. Accelerator left on there. It's not messing things up, but this should be alright. Buddy, move, you're full. Next truck. Go. No time to waste. Let's go. Looking for the full bucket? Should be fine. Let's go. We're 98% there. Except the snow stopped, but not much really accumulated by the looks of it. I still have milk on the dairy farm to deliver. Bet I do. But I couldn't be right by him? Or do I have to Yep. Not to deliver. I knew it. Who has made it to the mine? So I want to get to time my bulldozer out. Even though it's getting dark now, I might just have best luck just wait until tomorrow. I'm going to start on the ramp on this side because there's no active trucks there. Doesn't seem to let me choose my material. Both up there. One of those yellow style lights that it has. For a look, but really it's too dark to use this thing at this point. So we'll wait till tomorrow. Switch back to the dairy. Give it a little save here. Make sure that's done. And we'll be on our way. Slip away. February 2nd, here we come. Oh, the truck finally made it pulling. Jolly good news. I imagine our cows are looking well. Well enough. I might just jump right back. I'm just so excited to try that bulldozer out. Hopefully I can. Before the rain gets it. Interestingly, this bulldozer doesn't give us many options. It's either lower or discharge material, so the other one seems to even give us more options. For some reason it dropped rocks out there. Tool on the back is confusing. But it still doesn't explain a lot. Okay, now we're on track from material. And we can choose a material to be dirt. Very good. It's interesting that you can't lower the bulldozer. Oh dear. That's not happening. Rocks have really come kind of annoying. Not much I can do about it, but we're getting closer. The ramp up is still the most difficult part by the looks of it. But this is a nice flat smooth area up top. I think we get that. Ooh, dang it. Dropped off again. Something you sink into the loose dirt material more than you do the hard dirt ground material. So you gotta play with your motor bucket to get that level flat surface. Really trying to get. Eventually. Kind of decent. Now you have to get this up to the very top and play up there to get it all leveled and smooth for the trucks. The ramp road. Maybe the other unit is best for that. This might work good for just smoothing off the ramp road. A team effort to produce one of those. Look at some of this off on here. I'm gonna have to end up redoing my whole ramp road out and then snow. So it's pretty well shut her down for now. There's no snow here yet. I'm sure it's working its way down here. It'll get here, but nothing yet. Is it DOF off? That's a bit better. There it is! Takes a while to get across the map. Which means we'll maybe just go. I don't know. Maybe I'll shut her down here. We'll do a little slight bit of snow plowing next time and then get into spring. So, thanks for watching so far. Hope you've enjoyed. Leave a comment and a like, and we'll catch you on the next episode.